So today we're going to take you through the new 99C revision. We built a 21 from start to finish, so you can see all the different stages of what it takes to make one of these speakers. The 99 series is our loud and long playing series, so it's the biggest voice coils, the biggest motors, the biggest and best of everything that we do. The original is sitting here. This is a 9917, what we used to call the beast. And some of the motors, as we went from start to finish through its evolution, and some experimental motors that we did. The new 99C revision gets the new heat sinks, gets the new spiders, and revisions to the voice coil. So with that said, we're going to take you step by step to what it takes to make one of these for you. So for the 99C that's coming up for its debut, we're going to do a throwback cone. A lot of our customers remember the original Beast was an all Kevlar cone. So we're going to do a high performance variant of that Kevlar cone. So the back of the cone is going to be a plain weave Kevlar, which we see here. With that plain weave Kevlar, we're going to do a plain weave carbon. And then on the front of the cone, we're going to go to a crow's foot Kevlar fabric, which gives us a little bit more dimensional stability, not just 0-90 degrees. We throw in like a 60 degree offset on that. So these will be three layers on top of the composite core material that we always do. So the combination of these fabrics, Kevlar is rigid, but it has flexibility to it in the fabric. Carbon is even more rigid and stiff. And the combination of Kevlar and carbon fiber, when you put them together, gives you that ultimate high strength, but there's a flexibility to it. It can move and bend a little bit and not fracture. And the cones, then the environment that a lot of our products gets used in, there's a lot of flexing that can happen inside of there. So this combination of cones, what we call like our high strength, we're putting Kevlar and carbon on the back. Then we got our foam core, and then we'll have this crow's foot Kevlar across the front of the cone. It's gonna be very stiff and very light. So this 9921 is going to be done in a gloss finish. The fabric starts off being built up, piece of fabric on the mold, then we'll go to our core material, and then the rear fabric, and then the vacuum bag. So to have as nice a finish as possible, we need to buff this surface so that it's glossy and shiny. So now that we have the mold all polished and glossy, we're gonna start doing the buildup process on the cone. And our first layer is gonna be our crow's foot Kevlar. We're gonna then bond our core material that we cut on the CNC. Over the top of that's gonna be our carbon fiber and another layer of Kevlar. Once those are all resined and laid out and smoothed out onto the mold, it's gonna go over to the vacuum bag station. We're gonna bag this thing. From there, it's gonna go into the oven, and in about 12 hours, we'll have a cone ready to pop off and start the next machining processes. Okay, so we've got this beautiful cone that we put together yesterday. It's out of the vacuum bag. It's been popped off the mold and been cleaned up. So this is our crow's foot Kevlar on the front. On the back, we have our layer of plain weave Kevlar, plain weave carbon. It's all looking good. This is what we use to do the trimming of the cone, which we'll show that step coming up. After we get the cone trim to the right size, we're going to be attaching the surround. And this is the surround on our 21, complete with DD Audio logos. And this is our surround jig. So once the cone and the surround is done, we're going to start moving on to dust cap phase and picking out the dust cap weave that we want, the color that we want, and the logos that are going to go on this new 9921. Okay, so today we are working on the dust cap portion of our 9921C build. This is what it looks like when we have our dust cap on the mold. What this dust cap is comprised of is three layers of fabric. So we got two layers of e-glass and two different weaves that go on cross. And the top is a layer of carbon used with epoxy resin, gets baked for 12 hours, and then we size them. So these are going in tonight. They'll be done tomorrow. We'll take them downstairs and size them for the different speakers that these go on. Yeah, so this is the iron cloth spiders they're going to use on the 99C revision. We do standard suspension, has two of these layers of really thick, heavy resin spiders. And then for our extra stiff, we use a triple laminate version that brings the free air up higher, and for long-term high power handling is going to last a long time. So in these versions of spiders, we can stack and adapt them to whatever application we're going to have. Standard is a two-layer suspension. Extra stiff is a three-layer suspension. And some of these wild extreme vehicles with 25 to 50,000 watts of power per driver, we can start stacking these and do called a triple-double. We can do two triples if need be. So whatever suspension's out there, we can do a version to suit that application. So all of our spiders are, we tool them in the US. It's all US fabric. They're all done here. It gets shipped to Oklahoma City, and that's where we take our CNC laser and we cut them to the individual sizes for those speakers. So in this spider here, it's designed to be able to use with a 3-inch voice coil or a 4-inch voice coil setup. The 9900s is a 4-inch voice coil, so we're going to be setting the laser up to cut 9900 size spiders today.
So since we've upgraded to the iron cloth spiders and they're so saturated with resin to provide good longevity and toughness, they're so saturated that we have to press them with our pneumatic press and then break up the resin before we cut them. And this also provides a little bit of pre-break-in before you would actually do a break-in. Otherwise, who knows how many hours you would have to break them in on an amplifier. So once this is complete and they're stretched, then we can take them to the laser, and it actually helps them cut a little bit easier as well, because we've loosened the resin and makes them overall easy to work with for production. So in order to place them properly within our laser cutter here, we've created a plate jigging system. And to get them centered up properly, we have custom 3D printed tools that we developed that allows us to ensure that they are on center and stay concentric with where they're supposed to be in the laser. As if you cut them off center, the woofer gets built off center and you run into tensioning problems and things being offset, which can cause non-linear throw, which we all know is bad. Once we get them in the laser, we have to set the proper focal height for the laser to cut at. Much like a flashlight beam, the farther away from a surface you get, the wider the beam gets, and we lose efficiency in the cutting process. An inaccurate cuts and wide cuts takes away more material than what would be needed and takes a lot longer to cut. One other interesting fact about the iron cloth spiders, since we upgraded these, with the combination of having to pre-stretch them and break up the resin, we also had to upgrade our laser cutter's CO2 tube to 150 watts, which is certified to cut 2 millimeter steel, because the old tube was much too weak to cut these. And if that doesn't say how tough the spiders are, I don't know what does.
So now we've got all of our parts assembled here. The cone that was done upstairs in our composite room, the dust cap. The rest of the parts are assembled here and it'll start going through its assembly process. We're gonna do the dust cap station first. We'll do spiders and coils and then on to final assembly, testing, and see how it looks before we go into final pack. Hey, so we've taken you through all the steps that it took to build this 99C. It's a woofer we're very proud of. What we'd like you to take from this is that care and time and all those steps you saw is what it takes to build all of our subs here. And from a 1506 like this guy to the 9921, this is what we like to do. We like to build great products for great people. And hopefully you give us a chance to build one for you.